we are going to learn three of my favorite clavinet-based grooves. First, of course, Superstition. Stevie Wonder. Can't do a clavinet guided practice session without that. Of course, Use Me, Bill Withers, one of the most famous clavinet riffs ever. And then one that you might not expect, but is really going to be, this is where we are going to make our money today, right? Mothership Connection, Parliament. We are going to live inside the bubble of one of the funkiest grooves ever played, ever recorded with Parliament's Mothership Connection. It's going to get nasty. It's not going to be nice, but it's going to be great. Look at Bill there. Bill Withers having a ball on Soul Train. We've got some Soul Train lined up for you. If you're too young to remember Soul Train, I feel bad for you. I do. So we also have a PDF here. You can download that PDF. Ian's going to put the link in the chat. You can check it out in the description. It's got all three of our iconic grooves there if you want to check that out. Make sure to download the PDF. Always a good idea. And as always, if you want to go on a deeper dive of any of this, you can go to openstudiojazz.com, where we do this kind of stuff all the time. Although this is pretty different. We've never done a sort of deep groove practice here. So you can go to openstudiojazz.com, check out everything we do. Also give this video a like if you like some deep funk grooves here that we're gonna get deep into. So we have some goals. I have some goals in mind for this practice. It might not be what you think with this practice. So what is this good for, what we're about to do? Yes, we're gonna learn the groove. So we're gonna learn each one of these three iconic grooves. We're gonna learn what they're playing, but this isn't like, you know, when we learn McCoy Tyner language or Clifford Brown language or Bud Powell or anything else that we covered that's more, you know, in that straight ahead jazz vein. This is really going to be more about staying in the pocket. This is going to be pocket practice. This is really almost a meditative experience when you get deep into this. If you've never been as a pianist or as a keyboardist, if you've never been a part of a rhythm section where you don't have the freedom that you might have in like a straight ahead jazz situation, right? If you've only been like a cocktail pianist and if you've never played in a band where you have to be part of the rhythm, where you are part of that furnace, that engine that's making people dance, you are in for a treat today, my friend, because it's a whole other thing, this thing. And so what I really want to focus on, why I have that stay in the pocket highlighted, is because we're going to play these grooves in an uncomfortably long amount of time. I have them looped up in SoundSlice, and you can see what the groove is, but we are just going to loop them and loop them and loop them and loop them again and keep going. And what I want you to do is just notice a couple of things. Notice, if you've not done a lot of this work, notice how early you want to do something else. Like early on, as we're looping these, you want to break away and improvise something or take a solo. I want you to sort of fight against that urge if that happens pretty fast here. I'm going to give you a little room to make it your own, you know, because the people who are playing these grooves, they're not robots. They're adding their own thing. We want to be able to add and speak our truth to the music, even when we're a part of a groove, but you have to serve the music first. That's, I think, one of the best takeaways from practice like this and playing like this. As a keyboardist, we can really use what Chick Corea called our 10 drummers, right? We can be part of that rhythm section and really just surrender to the music, surrender to the groove. There's no better feeling in the whole world than being part of a seriously locked in, like happening pocket. It's so much fun. And that's what we're going to work on. That's what I really want to work on with this. I've done a ton of this kind of practice. I love it. And I was thinking recently of like, how can I do more of this on these YouTube videos? And I think this is the way. So this is the way. Again, keep in mind here, yeah, we're going to learn these grooves, but keep it in the pocket. Let's check out our first one. Speaking of Soul Train. Bam! Stevie Wonder. The great Stevie Wonder. And we're going to be working on... So luckily, you know, if you've never checked out Soul Train, again, I feel bad for you. But what it was mostly these performances were kind of like half recorded and they might be singing live, but there's definitely the record happening underneath here. So we get to kind of play along with the record, even though it's a quote unquote live performance. We're going to just hit this intro here and we're going to hit it again and again and again. Let's check it out. Let's check it out. ¶¶ it should be timed out right to come back on the beat. It's going to be a little hiccup, but... Sounds like there's a little delay, and I'll take care of that. But just one thing to note, let's just take a look here before we get going, getting in the pocket on this. Oh yeah, I've got my clavinet sound queued up as well. So what I have notated here is obviously not everything that's going on. If you watch this again, and you can watch what Stevie is doing with his hands, he's filling in a lot of space. Likely he has, you know, his pinky of his left hand. Let's see if we can get this up here. Let's see if we can actually get it up though. Likely he has the pinky of his left hand down here on this E flat, and he's got the B flat and the A flat going too in his second and third finger, and he's kind of filling in space. So if we start this kind of slow, something like that, where he's kind of using his second and third fingers in his left hand to kind of fill in that 16th note. And he's playing a much stickier sounding Hohner D6 clavinet than this Keyscape sound, beautiful Keyscape sound I have queued up, but it's not quite as organic as what Stevie's playing. So those moments that we have rest here, he's actually filling up as a guitar player would. If you think about, you know, a rhythm guitar player, Nile Rodgers or someone like that, just chunking away, right? The right hand never stops moving, and they're ghosting notes. You can do the same thing here on the clavinet. And by the way, on the piano, on the Rhodes, you can do it as long as you're kind of in the right range and you have the right setup. As we'll see with almost all of these grooves, it works really well. So that's the first thing, is see if you can listen and mimic how Stevie's filling in that space with this awesome clavinet groove. Let's see how the timing has worked out. I thought I had it worked out, but I might need to tweak it here. So apologies if we have to tweak. Let's hear it again. Yeah, we're gonna have to tweak. I'm assuming it's something as simple as when I went streaming, but no big deal. This is what SoundSlice is great for. If you don't know SoundSlice, go check it out. It really is hip. Let's try this. See if this gets still a little more. That's okay. It's important to set up your loops here so that you don't lose the groove, you know, as you're getting into it. Let's try this. As we're getting this together, though, practice the groove itself. Oh, closer, closer. Yeah, it's taking it a full, like, half second longer to get back than it did when I was setting it up. It's interesting. All right, let's try it again. I've gone too far. We'll keep learning it, and we'll keep getting those in-between notes here as we kind of set up our loop. Look at Stevie. There we go. All right, let's get into it. So stay with us here. Stay in this pocket. Fill in those other notes with your left hand, B flat and A flat there. See if you can do exactly what Stevie's doing. Again, before we get too deep in here, and we're really going to let this loop for quite an uncomfortable amount of time. I mean, I really want you to try to not do anything but stay in the pocket here. It's really hard to do, but the benefits are immense. So let's just check out a couple of things to note here on this first time through. I've already talked about kind of filling the space with the rest of our fingers on some ghost notes. But check out this first time through on bar two, the end of bar two. That figure's kind of on the beat, and at the end of bar four, it figures kind of off the beat. He anticipates that. He does that regularly. If you listen to the track, first of all, on the track there's like two or three or four clavinets layered, so there's a ton of stuff happening. But he does this regularly where that's where he picks his spot to do some different things. So I want you to kind of play it as written as we start here. When we get into it, I'll let off some of the guardrails and you can pick your spots and you can make it more human. So, because we don't want to be Groove robots. That's not what it's about. It's not about being a computer. It's about staying true to the groove. It's about supporting the rest of the band and the music, playing your part, right? It's something that as pianists, we usually have too much freedom. We're spoiled for choice. Let's be honest here. So to be a part of a rhythm section and really play that role can be incredibly thrilling and rewarding. And this is good work we're going to be putting in today. Let's get back to it. Superstition groove. I think I got it lined up close enough that we can keep it going. Let's keep it going. Come on. Stay with it. It's just a little rushed. The transition. Now we know that. We know that this drummer, quote unquote drummer, rushes on this transition. Sounds like drummer. See if you can line up right with Stevie. Make it feel just how Stevie's making it feel. Practice just staying right in that pocket with Stevie with our fantastic rhythm section of Stevie. Resist the urge to fill up any space other than keeping that part going. Keep that part true to where it is. Keep it going. You got this. All right, let's try one more way to do it here. I'm going to see if I can't. Before we try it again, I'm just going to make it just a hair longer. So we try to smooth that out. I think we're dealing with, you know, internet timing and whatnot. But let's do it again. Let's keep trying to stay in this pocket. And then I'm going to take some of the guardrails off. So I'm going to tell you, you get a little time. And if you want to... occasionally get into that. I'm going to throw it occasionally in, but we have to stay true to this pocket longer than we think we do. Let's try it again. Let's play with Stevie. Here we go. Stay with it. All right, take a little time for yourself here. Back to the pocket. Stay with that pocket. Stay with it. Notice how you're getting the urge to do something. All you gotta do is groove here. Don't do anything else. Woo. All right, Have some here. Have some here. Right here. Back to the pocket. Two more times. All right, say your thing right here. There it is. Look at Stevie going to town. It's a very young Stevie Wonder. Doing it up on Soul Train. Just amazing, huh? Just amazing. That's our first iconic clavinet groove. And again, the point of this is, of course, to learn the groove, but more than that, it's to practice staying in that pocket, staying with the groove, and playing our role as part of that rhythm section that, frankly, as straight-ahead jazz pianists, you know, we don't have to do as much as you would in this kind of circumstance. This is great stuff to practice for us. And you notice what happens, right? You notice that it takes a couple times through to really get into that, to where that pocket is and be able to lay in there. All right, let's move on to our next example. Bill Withers, Use Me. This is Ray Jackson on the clavinet. Of course, an iconic clavinet part. Let's listen. Isn't that great? It's fantastic. It's one of the great clavinet parts of all time. It's very, very simple. So it's just a simple chord progression too, just E minor 7 to A7. Just in octaves there, as you can see. Easily done, right? Yeah? Easy? No, not easy. Hard. Let's do it. Let's play along with Bill Withers' band live, Ray Jackson on the clavinet. And again, lock in that groove. Try not to fill in the space. Try to just get into the pocket. I think the timing on this one should be okay. Let's try it. Going, just stay with it. Don't add anything. Play the groove. It's how Ray Jackson phrases it. Mm-hmm. Woo. This time at the end, add your thing. Add a little fill and come right back to the groove. You got it. Stay with the groove. Just octaves here, just octaves. Feels great. Can you make it feel like Ray Jackson? Can you stay with the drummer, the bassist? Keep at it. Don't add anything. Not even ghost notes here. You don't hear Ray Jackson anymore. Feels so good. Woo! All right, at the end of this one, add a little bit of you. Right here at the end. That's it. Back to the groove. Said your thing. A support. Uncomfortable amount of time here. Know you're doing it right. All right, I'm gonna let you say one more thing in this next chorus. Pick your spot, pick your spot. Four more times, you got it. Say something here at the end. Last time here. One more time, because I lost the groove. Gotta go run a lap. Went to go host the guided practice session before I was done playing the guided practice session. Can't do that. Even as the host, I got to stay in the pocket. Okay. Isn't that fun? It's such a simple line. We've all heard it, I'm sure, a million times. It's such a beautiful tune too. Go check out all of these tunes. Actually, if you don't know Superstition or Use Me, where you been? They're amazing. It's amazing music. And if you don't know this next one, well, just buckle up. So we're going to play some Parliament now. Now, there's no looping involved in this, because if you know Parliament's music at all, the looping is built in. They're just going to vibe out on this riff for like 3 or 4 minutes before they change anything. There's some subtle changes that happen. And when you know actually the whole arrangement, if you check out everything that the master, Bernie Worrell, is doing here, who's the legendary keys player for Parliament. Bernie Worrell is one of the greatest musicians of his era, especially what he's doing here. He's playing the clavinet here. He's also playing all the synths and stuff on the original recording. This is a live record, and I don't see any keys in the video that I'm about to show you. Doesn't really matter. You're mostly going to hear this riff. The guitar is the loudest thing, but everybody's playing it. The guitar, the bass, the keys, everybody's playing it. And this is something that could change. It sounds dramatic. This could change your life if you spend enough time on this particular song, just staying in this pocket. It's amazing. So let's play it a couple times, because it's the whole piece is that we're about to do, the whole piece of this song from one of their live concerts. The whole piece is, I think, 2 or 3 minutes. So we can just let it go. There's one thing, too. If you want to download the PDF, you can see there's a variation a couple minutes in that's just crushing it. So I have it here in SoundSlice, but you might want to download the PDF. Ian will put the link there in the chat or the description so you can download that PDF and check it out for yourself. But let's enjoy yourself. Just let yourself be surrendered to the funk.
Return to claim the pyramid. Pardon on the mothership. I am the mothership connection. Get down in 3G. A light-year groove. If you hear it, noise.
I got caught up. So now you kind of know what the groove is. That's too caught up. You got to see what's happening here, actually. You got to see what's happening. Isn't that amazing? But let's watch this.
Return to claim the pyramid.
Don't add anything.
The mothership. I am the mothership connection. Get down in 3G. A light-year groove. If you hear any noise, ain't nobody but me and the boys. Turn the motherfucker out. Y'all ready to get down out there?
Stick with it. There's nothing else to do here. There's nothing else to do.
Give me a little more food up here.
Play the groove.
Well, all right, star child, yeah? Put a glide in your stride, a dip in your hip, and come on to the mothership. Stuff. Doing the loose booty.
Bernie Worrell.
Give me a little more food up here. Everybody sing. It's just me and the boys.
Don't add anything.
You gotta feel the band. If you hear it at all, right. It's just me and the boys. Come on with it, y'all.
Check it out. There's a little variation.
The band. The mothership connection. The home of the P-Funk. The bomb. I bet your memory banks don't forget this funk. Put your hands together there.
How much fun is that to be a part of that band for just a second, to just make believe be on stage playing that groove? Ah, oh, that's so great. That's so, so great. Yeah, not family friendly sometimes, the guided practice sessions, but that's okay. We're all grown ups here, right? Hard not to start dancing indeed. Now, I'm noticing I did do a bad bit of copy pasta here on the notation, but that's okay. If you're still reading the notation after about 15 seconds, you're doing it wrong. So just use your ears. That's just me in my own zone. It's going to happen. But we'll fix it on the PDF. You can download the PDF and it'll be, I just missed an eighth note rest there. It happens, you know. Let's do it again. And we're going to go out on this glorious, glorious riff all the way from the top. You don't need to see me. You need to see that again. Again, there's nothing to add here. Do you hear anybody, guitarist, bassist, keys, adding anything superfluous to this? No, nothing. There's nothing to add. You just stay in those pockets. You just find the spirit that's with you in the music right at that moment. Look at what you're playing with right now. You know, just release yourself to the music. This is what it's all about. So great, right? Thank you, everybody. We're going to go out practicing this groove one more time. Don't forget that variation. Don't forget the PDF there in the description. Let's do it.
Calling angel, we have returned to claim the pyramid. Party on the mothership, I am the mothership connection. Get down in 3D, a lightning groove. If you hear any noise, ain't nobody but me and the boys. Turn the motherfucker out. Y'all ready to get down out there?
Better than that.
Give me a little more wood up here. Well, all right, Star Child, yeah? Put a glide in your stride, a dip in your hip, and come on to the mothership. Doing the loose booty. Give me a little more wood up here. The home of the P-Funk, the bomb. I bet your memory bank don't forget this funk.
Yeah.
Come on, y'all, sing the song.
Listen to that bass drum.
You got to hit the band. If you hear
me and the boys, hit me. Four on the floor, it's you every time. Again, nothing to add here. Listen to what they're doing.
Put
nothing.
Your hands together out there. We're gonna say we can't get the mothership in here tonight. Real loud, and I want everybody to sing. It's just
You got hit the band.
Hey, Glenn!
When you hear six or
every time kills me.
You will feel your concept rumble in me. Jerry.